Students from IIT Madras have developed a prototype of a Hyperloop pod, a futuristic high-speed mode of long-distance transport as part of a global competition in Spain. A team of 40 students have worked online and offline amid the pandemic to improvise the model that they had developed 2 years ago for a competition in the United States. Take a look at those visuals. Now, Sam Daniel is with the Avishkar team at IIT Madras. Sam, over to you.
Thank you so much, Gargi. That's right. We come to you from the testing track inside the IIT Madras, where they are showcasing their newly developed prototype of the Hyperloop pod. In fact, they are participating in a global competition at the week-long Hyperloop Festival in Spain later this month. In fact, 2 years ago, they were part of a competition in California. They came on the top 21, and some more improvements have been done now to make sure they will turn lucky this time. And the students, through the pandemic, have been working largely online on this project. Thank you very much for your time. And Neil, for a common person who doesn't know what a Hyperloop pod would mean, explain to us, is it like a metro train?
Yes, Hyperloop is a proposed fifth sustainable mode of transportation in which mini metro trains like pods will be traveling in a vacuum tube, and they'll be able to achieve very high speeds because there'll be no friction and reduced air drag.
And what's the speed we're looking at?
So the proposed Hyperloop speed is 1,000 kilometers per hour, and that is what our aim is, and we're planning to achieve it in the next few years.
So for us to understand, say for example, if someone has to travel from Chennai to Bengaluru, how much time would this take?
It would take approximately 30 minutes based on our estimations.
Wow, that's huge. And why do you think we need this kind of high-speed transport? We have trains, we have metros, we have flights.
Yeah, so this is a fast-moving world. People want to move from one place to another very quickly. They don't want to waste time. So such high speeds are required. And another thing is Hyperloop is completely electric. Currently, all other different modes of transportation require combustion of fuels. But being completely electric, it is very good for the environment. And according to our estimates, Hyperloop is also very energy efficient, and it can take a one-fifth of the energy for a plane for the same distance.
All right. And tell me, how did you manage to work? Largely, all through the pandemic, you didn't have classes, in-person classes. A 40-member team, actually. How did you work?
So initially, we designed and made the simulations online. Then after 5 to 6 months of hard work, we came back to college in the month of April and then started working on the procurement and assembly. And then we faced a lot of difficulty during the lockdown, but still we assembled the entire pod and made it run.
Right. It seems you may have tough competitors. Even IIT Madras is participating.
Yes, sir. We have the prototype ready with us right now. Yeah.
And what kind of change?
An efficient version of the Hyperloop pod. So we have in propulsion, braking and suspension, we have made changes. We have replaced the rotary induction motor with linear induction motor. We have an eddy current magnetic braking mechanism instead of friction braking. And we have a semi-active suspension instead of a passive suspension mechanism.
Right.
We're going to test it this year. Yeah, those are the changes.
And how would you respond to criticism that IITs spend lots and lots of money? And sometimes these innovations could be irresponsible, as many call it. It may lead to job losses, environmental degradation.
So in terms of environmental degradation, this is actually a step up. So this vehicle is completely electric. So, and electric is the next thing. And in terms of job unemployment, I think it will take a positive turn because we have a huge infrastructure. We have to make a lot of tubes, and it can give employment in many various levels in terms of engineers as well as worker class.
Right. And how long do you think this futuristic mode of transport would take to become a reality?
So we are expecting maybe 10 more years for this to take people from Chennai to Bangalore per se. And we are doing our best to speed this up.
Right. Do you think India will soon get into this?
Yes, definitely. And I think we should get into this because this is something really extraordinary, and it's also a sustainable mode of transportation. And now, because the world is shifting towards net carbon neutral world, we should definitely get into this technology because it's completely sustainable and it will have net negative carbon footprint.
Yash, will students like you, based on this experience, will you take up jobs in foreign countries or really would think of starting up something?
So we are really passionate about the technologies that we are building, but the technology is not yet feasible to have a startup yet, a business model, and technologies are really experimental, but we will definitely try to keep working on these technologies.
Right. I see it's all boys. Is it an all boys club?
No, no, we do have two girls in our team, but it's just that they're currently not with us here.
And when is the competition?
So the competition is next week, Monday. Yeah, it'll go on whole week, 19th to 25th July.
Right. Although IITs have come in the top ranks globally, still in terms of research, IITs lag behind. Do you think projects like this would improve that?
Yes, sir, definitely. I believe like student projects like this will propel the research, especially.
Right. Thank you all very much for your time and wish you all the best for your competition that's coming up. So, Gargi, that's it. Team Avishkar displaying their prototype of the Hyperloop pod, which will be participating in that competition in a few weeks from now.